You're listening to the audio production of Habits of the Household, Audio Bible Studies, Simple Practices to Help You and Your Family Draw Closer to God, by Justin Whitmel Earley. Published by Harper Christian Resources and read by the author. These audio Bible studies are a unique learning experience. Unlike a traditional audiobook's direct narration of a book's text, this production includes high-quality live recordings that cover the important points from each chapter, as well as relevant material from other sources. This audio Bible study also has a companion Bible study guide sold separately.
Hi, my name is Justin Earley, and welcome to my hallway. This is my actual hallway, and you might be wondering, understandably, what am I doing here? Well, because I want to tell you a story of how God changed my life when I was standing right here. It was a typical Wednesday evening, and I was putting my boys to bed. Now, I have four boys, but at the time of this story, they were between newborn and seven. And bedtimes with boys at that age are exactly what you would expect. Lots of kids escaping from baths, lots of water on the floors of this 100-year-old house here in Richmond, Virginia, and multiple fights over who gets the Spider-Man toothbrush. That night, I was trying to get the boys to bed when I almost tripped on the bathwater on the floor, and something in me just snapped. I spent the rest of the evening muscling the boys to bed through my usual combination of yelling, chasing, counting to three, and physical threats, which honestly were not that unusual. And then finally, when I had gotten them all into bed, I said a quick prayer, I told them God loves them and so do I, and I shut the door. That's when I had the epiphany that changed my life. I was standing right here and I realized this is my normal. This is what it is like to live with me. You get a nightly dose of yelling, and then you get told that God loves you. And I started to wonder, what do they think love means? Realizing what your normal is can be pretty discouraging, and I definitely was. So later that week, I was talking about some of this to one of my pastors, and he told me about a bedtime liturgy he used with his boys. I was inspired, so it was then that I wrote my first bedtime liturgy, which may sound more complicated than it actually is. It was just a short little back and forth prayer, a series of short questions that I would ask them. And the idea was just to have some structure to bedtime. Here's what I wrote. It was called a bedtime blessing of gospel love. And the idea is I just asked them a set of questions and all their answers would be yes. It went something like this. Can you see my eyes? Yes. Can you see that I see your eyes? Yes. Do you know that I love you? Yes. Do you know that I love you no matter what good things you do? Yes. Do you know that I love you no matter what bad things you do? Yes. Now, who else loves you like that? God does. And then I'd say, rest in that love. Now, that might sound good on paper, but you can imagine how well this went the first time. It did not go well at all. I forgot what I was going to say. They were confused about the eye thing. They took it as a chance to poke me in the eye, and they didn't know the answers to any of the questions. When I asked them if I love them no matter what bad things they do, they said, no, you don't. We had a lot of work to do. But I did know enough about being a parent by then to know that nothing is normal until it is. And any habit is going to be messy at the beginning. But almost anything can become normal if you practice it a couple of times. So a good parent perseveres. Sure enough, about a week or two later, we had another night that changed everything. Now, in some ways, it was mostly the same evening. There was still bathwater on the floor. There were still fights over the toothbrushes. But as I got all the boys into bed, one of my boys laying down asked for his bedtime blessing. And we shared this short moment of exchanging the unconditional love of God for us, saying that no matter how today went for them or for me, God loves us in spite of our bad deeds and in spite of our good ones. Now, to be clear, other than this moment, the night was almost exactly the same. The big thing that was different was me. The circumstances were all the same, but my reaction to them had completely changed. And as I stood again right here in the hallway that evening, I realized that's the power of a good parenting habit. By changing our knee-jerk reaction to ordinary circumstances, we uncover new ways of letting God's grace guide our hearts and our children's hearts into new patterns of life together. And that is the great hope of this video series on habits of the household. I pray that these videos can help open your eyes to this wonderful reality that God will do some of His most extraordinary spiritual work in the ordinary hallways of your life. The reality is that we all live in a house full of habits. The question is not whether we have habits, the question is just what kind do we have? And habits shape who we are. In fact, you can say that we become our habits and our children become us, which means that habits of the household are one of the most important parts of our children's spiritual formation. Now, if that's true, we all need to have a hallway epiphany and ask, what is our normal? And if you're like me in this hallway, that can be a hard question. Your normal is usually not great, but don't beat yourself up, because another theme of these videos is grace. And the best place to learn the grace of Jesus is right in the midst of our failures. Because when we're truly honest about our messy normal, well, then we can be truly open to the beauty of God's grace. And the wonderful thing about that is that God's grace won't just come to us in the hallways of our life, it'll come to us in all the rooms of our life. So in this series, we're going to look at the way that God's grace can come into ordinary moments of the family's day, starting with moments of waking, and then looking into moments like screen time and discipline, family meals or family devotions. And in all of these places, we'll see something in common. That is that we all live in households defined by habits. And the goal of these videos will be to ask, if our household habits are going to lead us somewhere, then why not have them tilt towards the love of God, so we're constantly falling into the message of God's grace and love for us? So let's start in this video by talking about how we wake up. And I mean we, us parents, actually not our kids yet. Because guess what? Like everything else in the family, our habits start with parents. And the most important thing we can do when it comes to our children's spiritual formation is to look first at ourselves and ask, who are we becoming? Because we can only be good parents of children when we realize we are first children of God. So let's go to the beginning of the day and start with you. What is it like for you to wake into the role of parenting? Something you need to know about me is that I'm actually a full-time business lawyer. I now run my own corporate law practice, but when I first started, I worked in mergers and acquisitions at an international law firm, and I did a lot of work with our London office. That meant I was always working with law partners who were 5 or 6 hours ahead of us here in Richmond, Virginia. So every morning...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.